Let's check out amp number two. It's definitely the big boy out of the three. But with that high frequency driver, it really brings the sparkle out in the slap tone. Check this out. There. Another important difference that sets amp 2 apart from the other models is the compressor placement. On amps 1 and 3, the compressor is placed at the end of the circuit. You've got, you know, your input, the gain, the EQ, etc. Compressor's at the end. Perfectly logical, works, lots of people do it. On amp 2, and I'm going to switch to my B cam here so you can see what I'm talking about. On amp 2, the compressor comes before the EQ section. And I think the advantage of having the compressor in front of the EQ is that you can dynamically process your signal here and then work with equalization to bring out certain frequencies. You can sort of squeeze a little more performance out of the amp. Now let's listen to amp 3. As you can tell, it's not that much bigger than amp 1, but for my taste, having the two speakers splitting up the load gives this amp a little bit more oomph, a little more capacity. And of course, the 8-inch drivers have a little more high frequency response than the single 10 in amp 1, so it's a little clearer, a little brighter sounding as well. I've got the amp set completely flat, the controls on the bass are set flat, the tone balance section is off, the bass boost is off, and the color switch is off. So you're going to just hear the straight, flat tone of the amp. Now with the color switch on. I'm going to turn the color switch off and now roll in the intensity on the tone balance. Bring that all the way up with the balance straight up in the middle, boosting the lows and the highs. Now we'll hear the tone balance with the color switch up. Now I'm going to turn the color switch off, put the bass boost on, and the tone balance is still up full, set in the middle. I mean, gosh, that is massive. That's crazy. It's crazy. Now I'm going to have the color switch on, the bass boost on, and the tone balance section is up full, still straight up in the middle. All right, I'm going to get stupid with the low end here for a second. Why? Because you know you want to do this. And secondly, because this amp can really dish it out. So I got the low end boosted on my preamp, the bass boost is on, color switch is off. Check it out. All three AER combos have a well-organized back panel with all the input-output options you could need. There's a ground lift, there's a stereo headphone output, there's a line-out jack, there's a sub-out socket that provides a frequency-adjusted output signal for operating an active subwoofer. The foot switch input can be used to control the amp's mute function or effects loop on and off. There's the effects send and return jacks. There's also pre and post inserts. The stereo aux in has its own level control, and there's a tuner output. On the DI, we have pre and post EQ and DI level. So check out the slap tone on Amp 3. Because this is a very bright instrument, I've got the color switch off, which basically puts the amp into what I call vintage mode. But I'm getting my high end from the tone balance section, which is pinned all the way clockwise, which gives me an additional 10 dB boost to 10K. So there's my high end. I've got the bass boost on the amp and a mid cut dialed in. The bass is set flat. Contrast, let's hear the amp with my 72P bass with the 15-year-old Labella flat wounds. Dark stuff. That's nice. I hope you've all enjoyed this look at the AER Bottomline Combo Series amps for electric bass, Amp 1, Amp 2, and Amp 3. I myself have never seen anything in this size footprint that delivers this much low frequency response. It's usable low end. It's tight, it's well formed, it's punchy, it's robust. You can push the heck out of these amps and they just don't even break a sweat. The bad news? They're made in Germany, which means expensive. Amp 1, street price is about $1,800. Amp 2, street price is about $2,300. Amp 3, about $2,100. I know it's hard to wrap your mind around spending that much money on something this small, especially when there's lots of other amps out there that are in the same basic size category that are way cheaper. I'm just going to say it right now, you cannot compare these to those amps. These three amps are in a class all by themselves in terms of performance, in terms of output, in terms of low frequency response. There's nothing that touches this stuff that I've seen. If performance is important to you, it's worth the money. Great stuff. I hope you check it out.